Hello, this is Jake from the Corona team, and in the next few minutes, you'll be able to use denoising to dramatically cut down the amount of time and passes you need to get a clean render. And by the end, you'll know which denoising option is right for your render and which settings, if any, you'll want to change. To enable denoising, just head to your render settings and under scene, we have denoising. And you can see that we've got five options to choose from. And the first on the list is only Firefly removal. So I'm going to select that and put it on 20 passes and hit render. Only Firefly removal removes very bright pixels, which are also known as fireflies. These can occur when a really intense light reflects off of a very reflective surface. What Corona does is mix these really bright pixels with the ones surrounding it. So the denoising happens once the render is complete, and you can see that it happens very fast. And we still get plenty of noise with 20 passes. If we turn our denoise amount all the way up to 1, and turn it on and off, we can actually see what the Firefly removal is doing. Next up is the NVIDIA GPU AI option. And this is for fast noise-free previews during rendering. This denoising process uses your NVIDIA graphics card's artificial intelligence to determine how the image will look without noise. A massive plus to using the NVIDIA GPU AI is that the denoising happens in real time. So we can adjust the denoising amount whilst the image is still rendering. And if we turn it on and off, you can see what it's doing. So quite powerful. You can see though that if we turn this all the way up to 1, we do get some splotchy patches. So it's not ideal for final renders, but it can give us a great idea of how the final image is going to look. We can also use this denoiser when interactive rendering. And it doesn't actually matter which mode we select here, as the fast preview denoise during render is independent of the denoising options. You can turn that on and off under the performance tab, and as you can see, the NVIDIA GPU AI kicks in right away. One of the only drawbacks is that we can't turn this on and off in the frame buffer, and you can't change the denoise amount. Next up, we have Intel CPU AI, and this can be used for denoising when the render ends. It works in a very similar way to the previous denoiser in that it uses AI to approximate how the final image will look without noise. Only this time it's using your CPU rather than your GPU. And despite the name, the Intel CPU AI runs on any CPU, not just the Intel ones. And this is unlike the NVIDIA denoiser, which does require the NVIDIA hardware. So it's not as fast as the NVIDIA GPU AI, but it is faster than Corona High Quality, which we're going to have a look at next. Corona High Quality provides the best denoising quality. Really, this is your go-to denoiser for final images and flicker-free animation. This is also the only denoiser that can work with the recommended high-quality filtering options. The other denoisers will default to 10th for filtering. When you select Corona High Quality, we now get access to the radius as well as the amount. And the radius controls the size of the blurring effect. So lowering it can strengthen the details, but it will also lower the denoise effect. Unlike the amount, this setting can't be changed after the image is rendered. As with most things in Corona, the default is generally a good setting, so let's stick to 1. Something else to be aware of is that the Corona High Quality requires at least 2 passes to apply. With the denoise amount on 1, we can see a fully denoised image, but at the expense of detail. And if we bring this all the way down, we can see an undenoised image. So think of the amount as the blend between your denoised and undenoised image. Almost like opacity, it blends the two images together. And 0.65 is the default and will give a decent blend of denoising and quality. Last up, we have Gather Data for Later. And this enables you to process the denoising in the Corona image editor. And using Gather Data for Later will save some memory used during rendering. And this is especially useful if you find yourself running out of memory in a scene with lots of render elements that need to be denoised. And all you have to do is save as a CXR. And then over in the Corona image editor, we're just going to open up that CXR. And we can go to denoising and we can run that denoise. And a benefit to this method is that we can change the radius amount. Whereas if you remember when we denoised with the Corona High Quality in 3ds Max, we had to set the radius before rendering. And another handy feature is if you rendered with either of the AI denoisers, You can then use either of them in the Corona image editor. Which denoising option you use will depend on your scene and your hardware. In general, for preview rendering, the NVIDIA GPU AI will work the fastest and with interactive rendering. If you're not using an NVIDIA graphics card, then the Intel CPU AI will work well too. But when rendering final images, Corona High Quality gives us the best denoising quality and is the one that is recommended to use most of the time. Thanks for watching, and check out our other videos to explore what Corona can do for you.